Yep, Zatai has been known as the more lane dominant between him and Letmi. He has been known as a more chaotic type of player. Does like to play with his mechanics, push things a little bit, but is going to go for the safe option in the Mudo.
Are we getting him already?
What?
Have we got reworked Aatrox in game one of the Asia Rift Rivals? Is it gonna happen?
I don't think so. I have to say this Aatrox has not been hotfixed and is actually very, very weak. So I don't really expect the Aatrox in the top lane for in particular because he's not a very good dueler. But the Gangplank could be a mid lane, could be a top lane. Hanabi has been playing a lot.
Yeah, they still got a few more seconds before they switch things up as RNG still need to switch theirs around, but looks like it will be a pretty standard composition coming out of RNG. Very, very strong as far as just we can move in, we can get the Camille to engage. It's pretty standard stuff that we've seen a lot. It's a lot relying on Uzi. Standard RNG stuff. We're going to need him for damage in the later stages of the game. Whereas Flash Wolves of the jungle, as he's going to spot him. The level one Gangplank. This is exactly not where you want to be. And that is going to be First Blood going to Kasa. Shooting at a turret that doesn't take very much damage.
Level 6 from Fujin.
Yeah, he's looking for it. Flash does come in. The 2-for-1 special as they bring back the Tahm Kench. Grey health is eaten, but there's the Hemo play. Can they do enough? Looks like no. Is the Tide's going to teleport in? Yes!
Oh, he does.
Actually, it is. The pop with the Hemo play did so much work. Did manage to pick up themselves with the first turret. Speaking of which, this could be a massive problem for the Flash Wolves. Mugen going down, but can they retaliate? Bone Skewer comes in, casts it with the stopwatch, but it may not be enough. Deepwater Dive comes in. Oh! Messes up the hookshot, and that's going to be Hanabi with a much needed kill.
Now that you mention it, this is
and
a perfect
when you've got
counter
Impale, it's pretty fantastic. We need QSS to be built up by Uzi as the dragon being started. Teleport going to be invested very early in this fight. As Zatai seeing what he can do. Maple right in the backline. Hemo play already down, and they've got a dragon in this fight as well. That is huge. Hero's entrance comes in for Zhao, but will it actually work? As Impale brings in Zatai, and Betty grabs that kill. He can't actually use his ultimate. Yeah, and Killer Instinct, you know, pretty good, keeping you a little bit safer. Uzi does have options, as now I've got the engage from RNG. Already getting rid of Sword Art as Mugen. He goes golden so he can see his death. And that's the double kill coming in for Kasa.
Yeah, he's still running with his flash, but of course no stopwatch. Cannot
I just love how his like, run animation is so weird.
One
he's
more
just going to get killed once again. They've got it off cooldown. Does at least have the cannon barrage this time. Impale flies through.
In.
Oh, Ming! Beautiful use of the Devour to save Kasa, but he may have sacrificed himself. He has! It's going to be the ult coming down. Cleanse has been changed. But I just don't know whether it's going to be good enough as Kasa's going to jump in. They do have the Hextech Ultimate and they use it now. Hero's entrance comes down as well as Betty keeps himself alive for so long, but not long enough as Uzi finally on the board when it comes to the kills. Maple trying to get rid of him though as there he goes.
Does fall
down. Uzi gets taken down by the Hemo play, gets a double kill, but Maple is Xiaohu. He's going to get the taunt off, but that's not what he wants to do. He doesn't want anyone touching him. He's so incredibly low. The slow, the fracture, and Flash Wolf should get Baron.
Flash Wolves take down the fight 1-for-4. That was a good initiation coming out from RNG. Great, perfect timing, and even better play from Maple. Going into the back line and making sure Uzi was dead.
Well,
Bone Skewer lands.
Yeah, it's going to be a pretty easy one here if they can get Zatai to stop healing himself back up so damn quickly. He's lasting so long. Can he actually find it? No, he can't.
Baron take again by Flash Wolves.
Oh, it goes down extremely low, but they get the teleport, and there's the Bone Skewer onto Ming. A perfect target. They get rid of the Tahm Kench, but can they get more? Cannon Barrage comes down, all of the AoE ults on top of each other, as that's a
Maple
huge source opportunity. Huge for
Uzi
Kasa.
Down.
Uzi is getting a lot of work done. He picks up the first kill onto Maple, but now Xiaohu, he's gone golden. He's going to get taken out, and Uzi cannot get back in the fight if that's what he wants to pick up.
Oh, this is the big one, the second Infernal Drake. RNG have to go for this. I do not want to see Mordekaiser with double Infernal.
But they've only got two members here. We've got a Cannon Barrage. It's not even available yet from Hanabi. Thankfully, they moved themselves out of the way.
Right,
they're looking to try and get themselves a pick. Instead, they're right on top of the Mondo, but Hero's entrance comes down. It's not who they want to engage on. Justice Punch is interrupted, but Maple is now right in the middle, and Uzi right off to the side. They're trying to get damage in whilst keeping their eyes on him, and they do so successfully. Xiaohu goes down first. Bone Skewer comes in. Zatai is dead, executed with Death from Below.
Pike with the finish, and Flash Wolves are on their way towards the Baron.
They're actually just going to take down an inhibitor, I think. They feel like they've got enough. Uzi's protection has been taken down. Those big, beefy tanks for the frontline no longer there. As Kasa's getting zoned from his own base, In goes Sorda, gets himself another one. Ming, he's going to go down. Hanabi as well, utilizing the ult.
If they get one more pick, I'm losing. Slow goes out.
Boom goes the Dynamite with the Hemoplague. And Flash Wolves might be able to just win, teleport to keep the minion alive.
48 seconds on Uzi,
looking
there's no way.
Eats oranges, he's gonna be K. The ace comes in for the Flash Wolves. They'll take the inhibitor, and they're looking for the game.
Flash Wolves coming in with the revenge on Garza. Sure, he had the better early game, but he did sacrifice a lot of his experience. Flash Wolves with the worst 5v5 comp, consistently finding picks onto RNG's composition.
Just fighting in the right places as well.